Three actionable solutions to help stop police brutality. The problem of police brutality is a complex and multifaceted one. There is no single solution that will address all aspects of the problem. Instead, a comprehensive approach is needed that includes changes at all levels, from individual officers to police departments to government policies. Here are some actionable solutions that could help to reduce or eliminate police brutality. 1. Increase the educational requirement to become a police officer. There are several benefits to requiring police officers to have at least 2 years of constitutional law before becoming a police officer. First, constitutional law can help officers better understand their legal obligations and the rights of individuals. This can help prevent misunderstandings and conflicts and reduce the likelihood of excessive use of force. Second, constitutional law can help officers develop the critical thinking and problem-solving skills necessary to effectively handle complex situations. This can help improve their overall performance and effectiveness on the job. Third, constitutional law can help promote transparency and accountability within law enforcement. By understanding their legal obligations and the rights of individuals, officers can be more confident and transparent in their actions, which can help build trust between the police and the communities they serve. Overall, requiring police officers to have at least 2 years of constitutional law can help improve their performance, prevent misunderstandings and conflicts, and promote accountability and trust within law enforcement. 2. Require police officers to obtain malpractice insurance. Malpractice insurance is a type of insurance that protects professionals, such as doctors and lawyers, from being held financially responsible for any mistakes or negligence in their work. In the case of police officers, malpractice insurance could provide financial protection if they are sued for misconduct or excessive use of force. Having this insurance could help police officers protect themselves and their families from the financial consequences of being sued. It could also provide an incentive for police officers to engage in best practices and avoid engaging in misconduct, as failure to obtain coverage could prevent them from continuing to work as a police officer. Additionally, having police officers carry malpractice insurance could help improve accountability and transparency within law enforcement. If an officer is unable to obtain coverage because of their actions, it could be seen as a red flag and could prompt further investigation into their conduct. Overall, having police officers carry malpractice insurance could help protect them from financial liabilities and promote accountability and best practices within law enforcement. 3. Increase accountability through transparency. A civilian review board is a group of civilians who are empowered to review complaints about the conduct of law enforcement officers. Having a civilian review board that has access to review any police body camera footage for misconduct can provide several benefits. First, it can help promote accountability and transparency within law enforcement. By giving civilians the power to review footage of police interactions, it can help ensure that officers are held accountable for any misconduct or excessive use of force. Second, it can help build trust between the police and the communities they serve. By involving civilians in the review process, it can help ensure that the perspectives and experiences of community members are taken into account when investigating complaints of misconduct. Third, it can help improve the overall performance of law enforcement officers. By providing an independent and impartial review of police interactions, a civilian review board can help identify areas where officers may need additional training or support. Overall, having a civilian review board that has access to review any police body camera footage for misconduct can help promote accountability, build trust, and improve the performance of law enforcement. If you have made it this far, thank you for taking time to hear these actionable solutions to address the issue of police brutality. These are all promising approaches that could potentially help reduce or eliminate police brutality. In addition to the solutions you have listed, there are other steps that can be taken to address the issue of police brutality. Implement de-escalation training for police officers. De-escalation techniques can help officers manage situations without resorting to violence. Training officers in these techniques can help reduce the use of force in situations where it may not be necessary. Implement bias training for police officers. Implicit biases can influence an officer's actions and decision-making, leading to disproportionate use of force against certain groups. Bias training can help officers recognize and address their own biases and improve their interactions with all members of the community. Implement community policing strategies. Community policing involves building trust and relationships between law enforcement and the community. This can help reduce the level of tension between police and the community and improve the overall effectiveness of law enforcement. Implement stronger policies and procedures for handling complaints of police misconduct. Having clear and transparent policies for handling complaints of police misconduct can help ensure that officers are held accountable for their actions and that the community has confidence in the process. Implement policies to prohibit the use of certain tactics or equipment that have been shown to increase the likelihood of violence. For example, the use of militarized equipment or tactics such as chokeholds have been linked to an increase in violence and should be prohibited in certain situations. In conclusion, police brutality is a complex and multifaceted problem that requires a comprehensive approach to address. The solutions outlined above, including increasing the educational requirement for police officers, requiring police officers to obtain malpractice insurance, increasing accountability through transparency, implementing de-escalation training, implementing bias training, implementing community policing strategies, and implementing stronger policies for handling complaints of police misconduct, are all promising approaches that could help reduce or eliminate police brutality. However, it is important to note that addressing the issue of police brutality will require a combination of efforts at all levels, including individual officers, police departments, and government policy. It will also require a commitment to ongoing training and support for officers, as well as a willingness to listen to and address the concerns of the community.